Hi everyone, in today's video we're doing 5 under 50. That's right, in today's video we're checking out 5 things that every videographer should have in their camera bag under $50. Now these are 5 items that I've ended up using a lot as a professional videographer, but at the same time, it would be great for a beginner because these are things that you could pick up for super cheap and you can just use and get used to having, and they're really, really great to have. So first things first, a hot shoe level. You might not even see it from there. Hold up, let me get close. This little thing is a lifesaver. I mean, it seems stupid, it seems basic, but you put this on top of the hot shoe mount of your camera and it's ridiculous how much a difference it makes. So you just slide this on top here, and then when you're setting up your tripod or whatever, your slider, I mean, they always have sometimes one of these little levels on it, but I found it's never exact. It's never precise. And then if you move a little bit, it always changes. This is the top of your camera. It will not change. And so this is always straight up precise. You have a little bit of a level in your camera, depending on the camera you use. And I use that and it matches up perfectly with this. And this is always the one I use. So this is definitely a lifesaver, especially if you want to get those nice steady shots or you want to get those pans and tilts or whatever. This is what you should use because this just allows you to have the perfect level for your camera angle. I mean, I think you could pick up a pack of 10 of these for like $20. One of them is like $8. I don't know, but wherever it is, it's super cheap. Get it on Amazon. The links will be below. And this lives on my camera. It's always on my hot shoe because I usually never mount anything on top of my camera. So that's just always there. And it's super easy. Doesn't take any place and it's super precise. So definitely pick it up. Another thing that might be a little bit unconventional, a moving blanket. Yeah, just a basic moving blanket. You know those big blankets they use to cover your furniture when you move? Yeah, they cost, acoustic blankets cost like hundreds of dollars in professional video stores, whereas this costs $20. And the idea is this is super dense, and when you put it anywhere, it just kind of blocks out the noise and the sound. So if you're doing an interview or whatever and you want to block out a specific noise for the echo or reverb or whatever, you set this up right next to somebody, and what it does is it blocks out the sound. For example, check this out. Can you hear me a little better? It kind of blocks out that sound, and so this is a great thing to have. It also blocks out light. So if you want to set this up somewhere next to a window, you're blocking out all that light because this is absolutely not see-through. So just having one of these is like great all around. Sound, lighting, it's just, you must have one of these. You lay them down on the floor and you set up your interview on top of it. So you put a chair on top of it and it reduces the friction. If let's say the person moves and the chair moves a little bit, it reduces the noise that the person makes with their feet. It also helps with the bouncing of the sound. Just get it, it's $20. It's super cheap, it's a blanket. This'll probably work one of your blankets at home. The difference is this is super dense and you're not scared of ripping it or dirtying it because it's super sturdy as well. So $20, it's a pickup. The next item is a softbox. One of these cheap softbox kits will maybe set you back like $45 for one light. Sometimes you can find kits for $50, you get 2 lights. You have to look online, but one of these kits are super cheap, and what they do is they come with this softbox, which has a diffuser on top, and it comes with this bulb. And you put the bulb inside, and you get a really cool light source. This is just straight up, no diffusion, but you throw the diffuser on top, and you get smooth, unified lighting. And so this is really nice, especially if you wanna do kind of this kind of YouTube setup. This is really great. You just put one light here, and you just get a smooth light. You can also put it underneath wherever you want because these are super light. And for product photography or videography, you put this overhead and you have a beautiful tabletop setup. So these are super versatile. They're super cheap. They're great little lights to have, especially if you're starting out. They're not super powerful, but hey, they're good enough to get you started. And they usually come with a light stand as well. So just having a light stand laying around is also a great benefit. You hook up anything to a light stand. And so these are a must get. Now, another thing you must buy, especially if you picked up a light like I just told you, is a reflector. And so the idea with this is if you have, let's say, one light, like the one I showed you, this allows you to kind of have an extra way of bouncing that light and kind of, you know, controlling that light. So let's say this is the one light source that I have. I take this reflector, put it up here, and now it just filled up this side of my face with nice light. I take it out and you see there's more of a shadow. Same thing with the gold side. The gold side is basically the gold look. And there's actually 5 different ways of using this. So gold is gold reflection, white is white reflection. Open it up, you have a diffuser. And this diffuser allows you to put it right in front of a light and just lower the intensity of the light and makes it more of a diffused, nice look. And you have a silver side, so silver bounce, or a black side for black blocking out the light, kind of like the blanket that I showed you earlier. This is just a great thing to have, and these are about $15 on Amazon. So to have this just laying around is really useful, especially if you want to modify a light. This is a great thing to have. Now, let's say you don't want to spend the $15 or you just don't have time. Sometimes you're on a shoot or you want to get a picture and you want something quick and easy you can go pick up right away. Foam boards. These foam boards cost about $1 for 2 of them at the dollar store. They're super cheap. It's made out of foam. It's basically a piece of foam. And then the white one bounces light and the black one blocks light. So if you want to do the same thing here, you want to fill some light, you could do it with this. And if you want to block out light, you can do it with this. So let's say you just want my eyes to have light on it, you can do that. Versus with this, you can bounce light and you can actually cut these up. And that's what's super interesting about these foam boards is they're so cheap. You can have like 20 of them laying around the house and you can cut these up the way you want. So let's say you want to shape this light to look like a star, cut a star shape into it and that's your shape. They're just super useful to have and super cheap that there's no reason for you not to have them. And last but not least, an ND filter, especially one of these gradual ND filters like this one. The cool thing with this is you can basically lower the amount of light that comes into your camera at the lens. And so instead of playing with your aperture and shutter speed to kind of change up your look, let's say you want to keep your shutter speed at a fixed level because you're filming video and obviously it has to match your frame rate, and your aperture, you want to get the shallow depth to feel still, and your ISO is at 100 and you're outdoors, well, this is the only way to basically reduce the level of light. You can't turn down the sun, right? So this is what you gotta do. And so you throw this on top of your lens. Right now it's at probably the lowest level, and then you can gradually make it darker. And what that does is it blocks more light as far as it goes. And so you just basically are able to still get a really shallow depth of field shot with a lot of light outside. So these are definitely a must have in any camera kit. You gotta pick the lens size you have though. So this doesn't fit in this particular lens, but it'll fit, let's say, on this lens. So just screw it on top and you can have a really cool ND filter for that. So great all around filters. And while you're at it, you should also pick up a UV filter. And these are clear, transparent. They don't do anything to the image. All it does is it basically protects your lens. They say it kind of protects for sun rays and this and that. Honestly, what I use it for is protecting the lens itself, because it, like you put a screen protector on your phone, your lens is made out of glass and you just don't want to break it or scratch it. And if something happens, it happens on the filter, which is $50, you throw it away, change it. And so it's super easy. You could probably pick up some of these for $20 to $30 to $50 to $100. There's super expensive ones out there, but definitely on Amazon, you can find a kit of these for like $25. So definitely check these out because these can be super useful for any videographer or filmmaker out there. Well, that was it. Thanks for watching. I just wanted to let you guys know I started a podcast called The Gray Zone Podcast. It's actually available on Spotify. It's on Apple Podcasts. It's pretty much anywhere you get your podcast from. And so the idea with the podcast is we basically do journalistic research, interview people, and do research on certain subjects that you might not know existed. On that note... A bit about the podcast, a bit about what we do here and why we actually decided to create this. So basically, yes, going in depth on subjects that don't really see the light of day. So I would definitely check it out if you're curious about that. The link will be below and I invite you to check it out. And as always, subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a big old thumbs up. Leave me a comment in the section below. And hey, I'll see you next time. Peace!